So, as I've mentioned in previous videos, Chris and I, when we got married, we had a very, very tiny ceremony. It was just our parents and our officiant. So, we are going to be doing another wedding ceremony, and we're going to celebrate our anniversary in kind of the style of our wedding slash reception, and we're going to be doing it on a budget. One of the things that I was using to try to help us along this journey, since it is going to have a lot of wedding elements to it, was that I thought I would use one of those wedding planner websites. And I was going to use theknot.com, and that's not working out so great. Before I air a list of everything that I don't like about The Knot, I thought I would actually start this video with the things that I do think they do well, because there are some things that they happen to do well. Number one, and it's not something that's been a huge deal for us, but it's still very interesting and I know it's helped other people, is that their site and their blog seem to have a lot of really useful and helpful articles. And it's for a lot of stuff that either you don't think of or can help make decisions. So that's actually a pretty nice feature, and sometimes it's just really interesting to read those even if they're not super relevant. Number two is the checklist feature that they have on the mobile app, and I'm assuming also on the website, which I don't use nearly as much. And that's really handy so that you have a list of literally everything that I think you could probably think of. So everything from everyone's outfits down to accessories, down to booking all your different vendors, your paper goods, gifts and guests and everything else. So the checklist is really, really handy. It's also very editable, so if you are having a non-traditional type ceremony, you can actually make some changes to the list as well, and you can also change the dates on it, and I think that's really handy to have. Number three is another item that's not super relevant to us, but having a timeline for the day of, and it's got it where it's like what time you're waking up and what you're having for breakfast and when you're getting hair done, when you're getting makeup done, when you're getting to the ceremony, like all of that different stuff. It's in there as a timeline for the day of, and I mean, not using it, I don't know, but it seems like it's really, really handy and really well laid out. Number four is I really like their guest list feature, and it lets you not only enter people's names, but their relationship to you or your to-be spouse. You can have VIP guests, you can label them as family or friends, and that's been really handy because it's actually helped us keep a pretty decent headcount. So that's been nice just to have as at least a starter item for us. Number five on this list is suggesting local vendors, and this app, of course, is full of sponsored ads for all different types of vendors. Mostly it seems like photographers and florists, but there's actually a really solid list of local vendors, and it can be as local as the city or town that you're in, out to as far as like an hour plus drive away. And it does only work if the vendor is somehow entered into the app. So if somebody has a really small home photography business and they do wedding photography, if they're not in some sort of registry or list or whatever, they won't show up in this app. But those are the kind of people I feel like you would be more likely to find out from word of mouth anyway, and so you do have to manually enter them if you are going to choose your own sort of small vendor. But just having the suggestions is really nice, and it's really been handy just to kind of browse around. So now we get to the list of things that I don't like about using The Knot, and I primarily use the mobile app for setting this up, although I have been on the desktop version before, but not nearly as often. I find it incredibly difficult to navigate. Like, one of the biggest examples is trying to pick or set up your wedding colors, and you have to scroll way down the home tab or whatever. And then you have to choose wedding vision, and then you have to take a quiz, and then you have to pick your colors, and then you have to keep going all the way down into the wedding vision part of the homepage, and then you have to scroll down again inside of that just to see your wedding colors, which I think is incredibly irritating. You should either be able to edit the homepage so that it's set up more like you want, or honestly, something that you're going to be using pretty frequently, like wedding colors, should just be easily accessible on the homepage in general. And that's even after you assume that the wedding vision thing will work the next time you're on there. One of the biggest problems I have is that it's kind of 50-50 when I get into the app. If I click wedding vision, sometimes it'll say that I've never taken the wedding vision quiz. And that drives me nuts because you can close the app, reopen it, and then all of a sudden it'll be like, oh no, you totally took it. Here's your colors, here's your vision board. And it's like, what the heck? Along these same lines, I end up where I get constant error messages. And this has happened on the desktop and the mobile version, where I just get error messages for like everything. Like sometimes it'll just say, oops, we can't find that. Oops, we can't do that. And then you refresh and click again and it works. Or there's certain things that I cannot get to work in the mobile version at all whatsoever. And we'll get to that in a minute. But like, it drives me insane. Also, going back to what I said about the checklist being extremely customizable, that's great, except also it sometimes loses items and you don't realize it till the next time you open the app and it's reappeared. It is maddening. It is just maddening that you're pretty sure you added something or you're pretty sure you changed something. Then you start to wonder if you added it under the wrong date or maybe you typoed somewhere in there, and then all of a sudden the next time you're in there it's back and you're like, well great, now I have a second version of it because I thought it was missing, so I added a new item. The other problem that we ran into is that I tried to add our Amazon registry and it gave me an error message, of course, and it said I needed the HTTP or HTTPS on the beginning of my link, and it was there, I could see it. I had highlighted the whole thing and put it in, and it kept giving me the error, and then all of a sudden, randomly, one of these times, it just worked and it connected, and then it proceeded to disconnect on a future usage, and then it was there again, and then it was gone, and I don't even know anymore. I cannot tell you if it's actually working or not. I think one of the absolute worst parts of their app and desktop is the option to make your own website. And it shouldn't be this bad because it should work just as well as like any other social media type platform where you make like a public account, or at the very least, it should not be so broken. One of the first complaints I have is that, kind of dependent on which theme you choose, your photo might just be bananas looking. Like, we had one of our wedding photos as the cover photo, and on the mobile version, it looked fantastic. Then I went to the desktop version, and I have never seen anything blurrier in my whole life. So I searched around and tried to find the specs for what the cover photos were supposed to be, and of course their customer service was like, oh, it should be this wide, and that's great, but you need a height too. And like, even with the specs that they sort of suggested and that other people suggested, then it looked really, really good on the desktop version, and then there was text running straight through our faces on the mobile version. It just manages to look terrible when you have it look good in the other version. It just, again, makes me insane. There's also items that I seemingly can only edit from my phone. I have tried using the manage pages and the edit pages and everything else, and when you look at the homepage of our site, it's got this whole area that when I set it up last year, I added like location, some extra details, a few little odds and ends because our venue is a little weird, so there's some other things that you need to know about it. And then I was like, oh wait, I need to make some changes to that. And I literally cannot figure out how on the desktop version, but I can change it on the mobile version. And one of the biggest reasons that this drives me so nuts is I'm not like just the regular average user, I do web design as part of my job. Like, it is part of my career, and I use these sorts of interfaces where it's kind of pre-built and you can just enter the info. So the fact that I cannot find that option on the desktop version means there is no hope for somebody that doesn't do this sort of thing regularly. Like, what a way to set people up for failure on that. And I still don't know how to edit some of these pages. Like, I've seen some of the other sites that people have set up where they have changed certain things, and I cannot find it in either the mobile or the desktop version on some of this. The other problem that I'm running into, which if you follow us on Instagram, you may have seen me put up the error message, is I cannot make it publish the site from the mobile version. I just cannot. I keep getting the same error that's like, tap the banner to make it visible to guests or whatever. There, A, is no banner, and B, no matter where I click, what I click, it does not make a difference. Nothing will allow me to publish. But if I go to the desktop version, there is an orange banner that runs across the top that will say, make it visible or make it public or publish it or whatever it says. And I swear you can only publish from the desktop version, which is still maddening, because if I just went through and made some of my edits on the mobile version, then I don't want to have to publish from the desktop computer. That's stupid. The other problem that I have, and this kind of goes back to the checklist too, there are times that I will make an update and then I don't see that update reflected, and then I might get out of the app and get back in, or get out of the web page and get back in, and then all of a sudden it's there, and then it's gone, and then it's there, and then it's gone. If I made an update, I don't understand why it flip-flops like 15 times. Like, there are updates that I swear I am seeing that I made almost a year ago when I initially set this up. And then I'll refresh and it won't say that anymore. So I don't even have a screenshot example, because it's really, really random whether stuff is broken. I think one of the things that drives me kind of the most nuts with all of this is that I have both left a review in the App Store on iTunes, and I've actually written to their customer service for help as well. And they just say like, oh, we don't see any errors, or it looks like it's fixed. And when you make a suggestion, like I have actually suggested before, being able to put your wedding colors front and center, and numerous people online have said the same thing. They very, very unhelpfully say, oh, you just scroll down the homepage, you click on the wedding vision or whatever it is, and then you scroll down and there's your colors. And it's like, I get that, but what I'm saying is that I would like to see that option moved. Like, I would like to see it customizable so that I have easy access to the information that I want easy access to. And that's what other people are also saying. And even when I write back and say, this is just a suggestion for a future update of the app or the website, they'll say, oh, we get that. They're located here. And it's like, I know where they're located. I'm asking for a feature update. And they've written back again and been like, oh, we understand what you're asking. They're located here. And it's like, I get that. I'm not even asking for you to make this change right now. Just tell me you're passing the feedback on to your development team. You don't even ever have to do anything with it. You can lie to me and tell me that you passed that feedback on, but like, just acknowledge that someone has made a suggestion. But even when you look at forums online that people will make that exact same suggestion, they get this same runaround where it'll be like, oh, it's located here. And we're all like, no kidding. We know it's located there. It is absolutely located there. That's where we don't want it. And they'll write back and be like, it's located here. And it's like, oh my God, that's not the point. The point is that we're making a suggestion to make it easier to use. And It's like this. I've seen people make other suggestions for other features as well, like moving certain things or updating things or being able to reorder things or whatever it is. And their customer service will just be like, oh, that option is here. Or, oh, we have that option. It's set up like this. And they'll be like, right, I don't want it set up like that. This is my suggestion. And they'll be like, the option is set up like this. Why? Like, it just makes me bananas. And like I said, it's not like they have to make these changes. Just say thank you for your feedback. That's all you gotta say is thank you for your feedback. We will consider it. Because it kind of makes me wonder when they don't say that they're passing on your feedback or considering your feedback and they're just telling you where the thing is or that it's still set up that way. It makes me wonder if their development team even knows what feedback they're getting on social media or the app store or the forums or whatever. Like, do the people that make the app or the website even know what people want? Or are these like just two completely siloed departments where the customer service team is like, here is the thing that you didn't ask for, and the development team just thinks everything is okay? I don't know. That may be presumptive. I couldn't tell you. It just seems like for the number of repeat suggestions that they get, that they don't seem to be acknowledging them. Again, just from doing like user experience with websites and things like that, even if we don't implement a change, we will say, thank you for your feedback. We're considering it. Because when you get enough of the same suggestion, that's when you really, really do need to consider it. Or at least offer an alternate option or something. But anyway, that's enough complaining on that one. But the big thing is just, like, I have found the Knot so frustrating to use that I have honestly made the choice at this point to just include all the relevant info on our invites. And I'm designing the invites ourselves. We're not even going through, like, you can be part of the Knot, or I think Zola is another site, and then you can choose to order invites based on like the theme you've chosen and stuff. I do graphic design for a living. I'm just making our own invites. So that's pretty arbitrary for us, but like, I just cannot use this website. I've set up our RSVP as like a SurveyMonkey, which I'll get into that a different time. And I just cannot use the Knot. I mean, we don't have enough info to put on there anyway, because for us, this is gonna be an anniversary / reception party. This isn't even gonna be a full wedding. So there's just so much that we don't need on there. I don't need an online guest book. I don't need an online photo album. Anyone that knows us on Facebook has already well wished or seen photos or whatever. So those are all whatever for us. And honestly, even the registry thing, people asked for it. I'd rather send them a link by email or put the link on the invite rather than try to direct them to the Knot and then direct them from there to the registry site. Like, it's too much go around for something that could be very, very simple. And so I am simplifying, and I am just not using a third party vendor anymore for any of this planning. I've honestly had better luck writing stuff down in a notebook and checking the items off. So if you've had a better experience with the Knot, then leave a comment down below. Or if you're frustrated about the same things, leave a comment down below. Or maybe you got married pre-internet era, I don't know. Maybe you have always done the paper and pencil method or whatever. I'm curious what you have done for your own option, or what you would do if you are not married yet, or, you know, whatevs. Leave a comment. I'm rambling. Just leave a comment and leave a like and subscribe and do the whole usual thing that we ask for. And hopefully Chris will be in the next one. I always end up recording these when he has a bunch of work and then I have like a day off or a couple hours extra at home. So hopefully you'll see him in the next one. And until next time, guys, bye.